Behind me is the latest prototype from Singularity Computers, the guys that have been behind some of the craziest computer mods in the world. And their Spectre case, which should begin shipping to consumers in the next few months, isn't just compatible with water cooling. It integrates water cooling directly into the case with a pump and a reservoir built right into the back panel. So then, let's build an unnecessarily powerful computer in it, right? What are we waiting for? This message from our sponsor, Synergy 2. Synergy 2 makes sharing one mouse and keyboard between multiple computers so simple and seamless that anyone can use it. Check it out today at the link below. The first steps were to take off the top panel, thread our motherboard standoffs into the acrylic backplate, and add an RGB strip to the top for some sweet, sweet edge lighting action. Next, we added plugs to our triple 120mm radiators from Bits Power to avoid a repeat of last time. Then, we pre-tapped the radiator holes and tried to attach them to the case, but without luck. Our case is actually a little bit too thick, so we're gonna have to live without our orange anti-vibration dampers. The wires for the RGB and front I/O then needed to be hidden under the front panel. And as it turns out, front USB wires are a lot thicker in real life than they are in CAD. So getting the front panel back on was quite a struggle, something that should be fixed in the next prototype. Now the choice of CPU for this project was pretty easy. We went with the 18-core Core i9-7980XE Extreme Edition. And since the point of this case is no compromises water cooling, well, we took our CPU for a spin in our Derbauer X299 de-lidding tool, replacing the stock thermal compound with a very light application of liquid metal. Now, we're not expecting to break any world records, but we would like to get close, and replacing the TIM on these chips is a must for the best overclocking results. Our GPU choice was equally simple. The Titan V is the most expensive and most powerful consumer-ish card on the market. Now to water cool this bad boy, you first remove all the screws from the bottom to release the factory heatsink and wow, holy crap, there's a lot of thermal compound in here. So the next thing you'll need to do is clean all of that off, replace it with some Thermal Grizzly Cryonaut, and then attach a schmexy full cover water block like this one from Bits Power. The motherboard, a Prime X299 Deluxe from ASUS, is also getting the water cooling treatment. Now, if you guys think that the theme of this build is water cooling, then you are wrong. It's LTT orange and black, duh. Anyway, we removed the VRM heatsink, added thermal pads, and then screwed on our Bits Power full cover block. With the components installed, we threw in 128 gigs of Trident Z RGB RAM. We gotta fill up all those slots, right? Installed our fittings, and then got down to planning out the loop. So, for the first couple of hardline bends, it was basically measure, cut, bend, test fit, get the length perfect, and then move right on to the next. But as we progressed through the loop, the bends got increasingly difficult. Like, this little guy up in the corner here needed to be done freehand, something that Alex had never done before. And while the rest were made a little bit easier with our brand new kit from AlphaCool, it needed a little bit of modification.
So now it can be totally straight up and down. Perfect.
A couple more bends later, the loop was complete. So for storage, we used 3 1-terabyte SSDs in RAID 0. So that's, you know, pretty cool for wow factor, but not quite as cool as the RGB SSD covers from V1 Tech that we installed on them. So huge shout out to Hassan for those and for the LTT themed GPU backplate. With the computer temporarily wired up to our Seasonic 1000 watt 80 plus platinum power supply, we were ready to see if it posted, and oh, wow. Well, you know what, it's okay. It just wouldn't be an LTT themed build if it powered on the first time, would it? So to fix the problem, Ivan and Alex came in on a Sunday to completely disassemble the computer and test everything. As it turns out, the culprit was some errant silicone. This stuff is used to glue deleted CPUs back together, but some of it got on one of the contact pads on the bottom. Alrighty, so after reassembly and some finishing touches, it was time to fill the loop with tap water to check for leaks and confirm that it was in fact totally working, then drain it and add some orange premix to finish off the LTT look. So, with the build done, we think it looks awesome, but if you haven't decided if you agree yet, sit back and enjoy some eyeball-tickling glam footage. But don't be fooled into thinking that this is just a pretty face. As expected, thanks to the ample radiator mount points and the open design of the Spectre, not to mention our high quality cooling blocks, the thermal performance of this thing is nothing short of fantastic. So at stock clocks, we left this thing running Unigine Valley benchmark overnight, and the max CPU core temp was 43 degrees, with the Titan V topping out at 42, while boosted to an outstanding 1912 megahertz. Then, after some overclocking, things got even more interesting. So check this out. With all 18 cores running at 4.8 gigahertz, Cinebench looks a little something like this. Wow! Crazy! I mean, there is basically nothing this thing cannot absolutely chew through. It's a total beast. And while it's hardly an amazing price-to-performance machine, in terms of raw benchmarking prowess, it scored number 5 in the world, taking that spot for Canada in 3DMark. And that is with a single graphics card. Pretty flippin' astonishing. So yeah, it costs 11 grand, but basically nothing on the market can beat it for performance or, in my opinion, for looks. So special thanks to James from Singularity Computers for all his help getting this put together. We are stoked to see the final product from you guys when it hits the market. Almost as stoked as we are to tell you guys about FreshBooks. FreshBooks is the small business accounting software that's custom built for how you want to work. It's a simple way to be more productive, more organized, and to get paid faster. You can create and send professional looking invoices in less than 30 seconds. You can set up online payments with just a couple of clicks and get paid up to 4 days faster. You can see when your client has seen your invoice to put an end to the guessing games, and they've got fully featured apps for iOS and Android so you can take the full experience with you on the go. So try it out for 30 days for free by going to freshbooks.com/techtips and entering Linus Tech Tips in the How Did You Hear About Us section. We're gonna have that linked below. So thanks for watching, guys. If this video sucked, you know what to do, but if it was awesome, get subscribed, hit that like button, or check out the link to where to buy the stuff we featured in the video description. Also linked down there is our merch store, which has cool shirts like this one, and our community forum, which you should totally join.